The early mornings are always a little damp and a little cool in the Delta, even in late August. The thick, cool morning air is laced with a flavored scent that is almost intoxicating. It is the smell of the Delta, rich gumbo dirt mixed with honeysuckle, cotton plants, and kudzu vines. It embraces you. It envelops you. And yet, in a few hours, it will become so hot and humid that even the catfish in the ever-near Mississippi River will have to rest at the bottom of the riverbed just to stay cool. This sweltering heat will cause both man and beast alike to move about at a slow draw. But oddly enough, the acres of fluffy white cotton that dominates the Delta landscape literally abounds in this intense humidity and heat. It is the cotton and the river that brings life to this part of the world. It is from this life and this culture that the seeds of a new music were growing and would spring forth, forever changing the fabric and structure of American society and the music of the modern day world. Memphis, Tennessee is known around the world as the birthplace of rock and roll, the home of Sun Records and Elvis Presley. But the story of rock and roll really begins across the river at a radio station 7 miles west of Memphis. KWEM was a radio station in West Memphis, Arkansas. I'm Mitch McCracken, and West of Memphis is the story of KWEM and its influence on music for decades. While rock and roll may have been born in Memphis, the mother radio station of rock and roll was without a doubt KWEM, which became the doorway that led to Sun Records. I'll be talking about the artists who started there, like B.B. King, Howlin' Wolf, Johnny Cash, Albert King, and even Elvis Presley. They all performed live on KWEM before they had recording contracts. In fact, KWEM was the only radio station that Elvis performed live on in the Memphis area before or after his first record. You'll not only hear their versions, but also their songs by the artists they influenced. Our first song is by a blues artist and KWEM regular that may have been the one who started rock and roll on Memphis radio. But before we do that, let's take a listen to what radio sounded like back in the 50s.
That's my rooster. Rooster, that is.
Oh.
What's the matter, Lizzie?
You talking about that old mean thing in the backyard.
You talking about Red?
Yeah, I'm talking about
Red. Shut up. Don't you call... Shut up. Don't
yes,
call
Pa.
Red mean.
But, Pa.
Let me tell you about that rooster.
Yes, Pa.
I got a great big rooster.
That was called the Rooster Song, and while that was playing on Memphis radio, across the river at KWEM, Howlin' Wolf was performing live on the air. Here's Howlin' Wolf doing his song, Little Red Rooster.
I have a little red rooster, too late to crow for day. I have a little red rooster, too late to crow for day.
The Rolling Stones covered this song, and it was the only blues song to reach number one on the British pop charts. The Stones did perform the song on several U.S. TV shows, including The Ed Sullivan Show and Shindig. In fact, the Stones insisted that Howlin' Wolf also perform on Shindig and was introduced by Brian Jones. Here's the Stones and Little Red Rooster. Thank you.
a little red rooster. Too late, he's a crow for day. I am the little red rooster. Too late, he's a crow for day. Keep everything in the farm upset in every way. The dogs begin to bark, hounds begin to howl. Begin to bark, hounds begin to howl. Watch out, strange camp people, little red roosters on the prowl. See my little red rooster, please drive him home. If you see my little red rooster,
in just a few minutes, the first song Elvis ever recorded, and it's not That's All Right Mama. But first, another blues artist that had a radio show on KWM was Sonny Boy Williamson. He was the most famous blues artist in the Delta. Now, while you may not have heard Sonny Boy, you have heard many of his songs, including Eyesight to the Blind, which was the only song not written by The Who for their rock opera Tommy.
Memphis and KWEM temperature is 75 degrees. Stay tuned next for Johnny Cash here on Mid-South Country Politics. Avon Theater time is 4 o'clock, and folks, I'm sure all of you have seen westerns before. But if I were a betting man, I'd bet you've never seen anything like Apache, starring Burt Lancaster and Gene Peters. Apache is showing on the widescreen at the Avon Theater in West Memphis tomorrow, Sunday, and Monday, in beautiful color by Technicolor. The other picture in this big double feature program is the spine-tingling A Man in Hiding. I'll make goose pimples on goose pimples. That's what it'll do. See them both at the Avon Theater in West Memphis today, tomorrow, or Monday for sure.